AVU link is the lifeline between the central place, that is IIT Bombay studio, and your place. If that link is down for 1 minute, you are disconnected for 1 minute. If one thing you have to do is keep your internet on and see to it that there is proper connectivity with AVU. And that's why the whole session now is given to Sajjan Dixit.
I am Sajjan Dixit, working as a project manager in this national mission project. So before taking the hands on, I would like to describe something here. So let us see first requirements. So the AVU, all are familiar with AVU software, I think. So AVU is a platform, a framework which the teacher can use for online teaching, and it works on internet networks. So most probably you will need internet line at your side, and it should be 1 Mbps stable internet line. So 1 Mbps stable internet bandwidth, you will require that line. Make sure that this line is not coming through your proxy server, because under proxy this software will not work. So take direct line, bypass the proxy in your institute. So we have a URL to check the bandwidth. So you can check your bandwidth using this URL. This is the URL 59.162.23.82/speed-test. So you can check your bandwidth, how much you are getting. Second requirement is personal computer, well configured personal computer. It should have Windows XP OS and with minimum 2 GB RAM. Third, you will need video camera with tripod. And please keep that camera under the projector so we can see the front face of your all the participant when interaction come during the lecture time. Fourth is professional microphone for audio. To connect camera to PC, you will require video capture device. It could be either PCI or USB. We are using here this device to connect camera to PC. This is the EasyCap device, but you can go with Pinnacle, Osprey, whatever you are getting in the your institute.
Is it available?
Right now we have 14 devices. So we can provide you, just write your name in the paper and distribute to other. So after the my demo, I will provide that device. But only, we will provide only those who are really trouble and they are not getting that device in the city, because we have log record, we tested your center. For audio, you will need 2 amplifier. With the speakers. one amplifier should be used for teacher's audio, one amplifier should be used for your own audio. If you do not have two amplifier, the single amplifier should be used only for teacher audio. Your microphone should be connected direct to the PC without using any amplifier. Otherwise, echo will generate. You cannot connect input and output in a single device. So I am making a diagram. Suppose you use a single amplifier. Take audio output from the PC and connect it to amplifier's auxiliary or input. Your microphone should be connected to direct to the PC. So if you have wireless receiver like that, so take output from this receiver and the another end of the cable, connect to PC direct. Do not use any amplifier in between your audio device and PC. Mic in or line in. If that receiver generates high gain audio, your cable should be connected to the line in option. If that does not generate high gain audio, connect to mic in option. If you have two amplifier and want to listen for this setup, if you use this setup, you will not listen, you will not get your own audio in the classroom. Because teacher can access your audio, but you cannot listen. If you connect this mic in this amplifier, the signal goes to this amplifier, teacher's audio signal goes to first amplifier, and your signal is also goes to this amplifier, and you are taking this output, so echo will generate. So please do not use single amplifier for your own audio. That should be only for teacher's audio.
Yesterday, we saw this demo of the session in SVID.
Yes, yes.
But I thought SVID was an old setup and we were having, you know, distinct echo related problems here.
Right now, yesterday there was no echo actually.
No, there was an echo when there was a feedback session. That
is coming from the classroom. We have a speakers in that teacher side classroom. So, that speakers is near that microphone. So the little bit echo is different. That is different. But if you connect wrong connection, echo will generate the same gain. So use microphone only when you ask, we want to ask a query or questions. And when teacher speaks, mute on that mic. So if you have two amplifier, so, disconnect that cable, use another amplifier. And that cable goes to in auxiliary of second amplifier. And connect separate speaker for this. And separate speakers for this. And take output from this amplifier.
That is preamp out.
Yeah, preamp out, line out. And if you use that second amplifier, the line should be connected to the line in option only, because it provides high gain audio. So this is the diagram for to reduce the echo, and you will need some connectors and cables as per the connections, whatever model you are using.
Can you tell the color of the connection?
Yeah, there are two input color, pink and blue. Pink is mic in, blue is line in, and green is the output. Pink is mic in, and blue is line in, and green is output of PC. You can see here, this is the line in, mic in, middle one is the output. Yeah, left hand side you can see pink color, that is the mic in, and the blue color is the line in. No, it would be better, you can use, but suppose you select wrong, you configure wrong thing in that laptop according to the AV connections, so you will get problem. So it would be better if you use desktop machine, because there is no camera inside that, there is no audio input inbuilt mic. So sometimes you forgot to select that proper microphone or proper camera, so you will get the problem. Cables and connectors. So these are the requirements to use AV. Now there are four phases, four states of AV. So first is login. When it's successful, it goes to navigation part. You can see there classroom, library, setup, feedback. So to receive the transmission from the teacher side, you have to enter the classroom. Select classroom. Now you will see the virtual classroom list. So now you have been allocated new remote center testing. Now we provide you another class, research methodology. So you have to enter that in that class. Just double click on that research methodology class. So after that, select class. You will get final interface of the software. So this portion covers teacher video, there are three tabs here, use online users list, chat box, and student video. Whenever interaction comes and teacher is interacting with other center, you can see that video in by pressing that student video tab. And by double clicking, you can see full screen also there. In this portion, you can see whiteboard and document. So when teacher changes the slide, it will automatically change at the same time. These are the interface. Now let us see the display mode. There are two display mode in AV. Single window, multiple window. You can see here the video part, users online users part and the document and whiteboard. There are four screens inside inside a single interface. So this is the consolidated mode. So we call it single window mode. So when you choose single window, you will get this interface. If you want to use multiple window, you will need a two display card in your system. So two display card, when you insert in the PCI slots, you will get four output. And extend the display and connect four monitors, four projector, and drag and drop that screen. If you want to use multiple window mode, then you will need two display card in the PC. When you insert two display card in the PC, you will get four output from the PC, four VGA output. And using that display card, you can extend the screens. So when you log by using multiple window mode, you will get all the screens separately. Video is separate, whiteboard is separate, document is separate, online users is separate. So drag each screen in each window, each screen.
Yeah, what is the benefit from this multiple?
You can see everything in larger screen.
You can see in consolidated mode now, but you can concentrate all the screens separately.
Is this for?
It would be better, but we are not recommending that you use multiple mode. If you have one projector, use single mode only. If you have four screens, then you can use. Yeah, this is not mandatory.
AView is a software which is not meant just for this purpose and this setup. It has many other uses. Okay, and I think the multiple window mode has created where instead of a projector, you have four LCD screens on the wall. Because there are smaller classrooms where instead of a projector, four LCD screens are put. Okay? And sometimes you have the same thing, maybe slightly different way on the four screens, or sometimes the same picture is just split into four corners and comes into four screens. Okay, just to get as if it's a one big screen of quadruple resolution. Okay? So don't worry about it. I think for us, if you have a projector, the single window mode is
it would be better, yes. So now how it works with server. So we have server here. Under this server we have three servers. One is database server for authentication. Second is video server or streaming server. For live video. And third one is content server. For whiteboard and document. So suppose this server is connected to internet. And remote center, multiple remote centers are connected to internet also. So when you log in, first request goes to database server and it uses, we are using here in the database part MySQL to, you are using that AVU, that is a desktop application. To connect desktop application to the server, we are using here LCDS, Live Cycle Data Services, and it works on port 8700. So if port 8700 is blocked by firewall or the router, you will not get the another interface. You will get the difficulty in the login. So suppose authentication is success. So you will go to next interface. Then you will, after the final interface, you will see their video, users, and all the things. So that comes through video server. The content works on content server, but you cannot see without getting the video because there's synchronization problem. If you get early, then you will not get the synchronization. So when video comes at your side, after that you can receive that content part. So video server using port number 1935. Suppose login is successful, but you cannot see users, your own institute name in the users list. That means port number 1935 is blocked. So you have to open that port in router and firewall. And content server works on port number 80. In every server, it is opened. So this is the basic funda, how it works. Now we take the hands-on. There are some checklists before start the AVU. If you are using Mozilla, Google Chrome, please do not open that. You should open only Internet Explorer because Windows XP taking all the default setting from Internet Explorer. So for this purpose, you should start Internet Explorer only. So start Internet Explorer, go to Tools. After Tools, select Internet Options. Now the fifth tab is Connections. Select that. Under that, you can see LAN settings. Select that. Make sure the proxy server checkbox is unchecked. Yeah, because under, deselect, it should be deselected. Deselected. Because under proxy, this software will not work. And you are using Mozilla, you called me that the internet is working fine, what is the problem? Yeah, so before start the AVU, open Internet Explorer, check the proxy setting. This checkbox should be unchecked. Type our IP address, our server's IP address, 59.162.23.82. Yeah, first check that ping, the server is pinging or not. So after that, type speed test. And check this, 59.162.23.82. You check your bandwidth. I am using data card here because if you use that card or use proper bandwidth, you do not have the adequate bandwidth at your side, you will get definitely problem. So I am using a older machine and the data card here. So it is taking too long time. That means the bandwidth is not proper. So you can see download is 0.55 and upload is 0.60. It should be around 1 Mbps. So it is less than 1 Mbps. So make sure that reading you will get around 1 Mbps. Yes, both the sides. Yes, around 1 Mbps. So that means speed is fine or not, you can check. After that, close this and insert your video capture device. So now you can see, I am double clicking on my computer. So you can see all the devices. When I insert this device, before that you have to install the driver of this device. I already installed. So you can see scan under the scanner and camera, Syntec STK1160, this is the device name. So it is detected, that means the device is working properly. If you will not get that, that means problem in the device or driver. So now double click on that and connect your camera's composite output to this connector, this input, composite in, yellow color.
HDMI.
No, it will not work. High definition, it will not work. AVU does not support high definition video. So I am using this handycam. So along with that handycam, you will get this cable. So this is the AV output. Please use only yellow color. We are not using handycam's audio. So please do not connect these. only yellow color, two in yellow color of EasyCAF. So now you can see video. That means camera is working fine and the device is working properly. Now close this. If you do not close, when you start AView, the application is running, the driver is running in another application, because you cannot use digital device in two application. Now after that, you should start screen camera first before start the AView. Screen, yeah, I forgot to mention here, along with AView, in AView software we are providing you, there are four packages. AView, screen camera, Java runtime, Adobe Air. So when you install that software, first it will install AView Classroom. After that, it will install screen camera. After that, it will install Java runtime. After that, Adobe Air. This is the runtime to run that whole application. So please do not update Adobe Air. There is a bug in version 3.2. So we are providing 2.5 version along with this software. If you get this type of window when you start the application, the installation is completed. After that, when you start the application, it will sometimes you can see this kind of pop-up. So every time you should cancel that. Otherwise, the video driver AView does not detect, AView driver will not detect actually. There is a bug in Adobe Air. So please do not update. If accidentally you updated, please uninstall AView, uninstall Adobe Air, both application from your ad remove programs, and reinstall that application AView. Only AView, along with AView there are four packages. So it will automatically install all four packages. During the Java, update Java also.
New centers have
checked it. Yeah, but that testing was only for selecting the centers. Now before the workshop start, yeah, but some of we faced many problems. Those who are already older center, they forgot sometimes to start. They are not following the best way to start the AView. It will provide you confidence actually. So start the select configuration. Go to webcam and the last icon you can see here is the configuration of this software, screen camera software. Select that. You will get a window. Select webcam there. Configure your camera for this software. Select from drop down your device. I have inserted the EasyCAF device, so you can see that device there. Select that device and connect.
No, I have a suggestion. Why don't you record this presentation
to become your own? Now we are recording. We have provided video also all the centers. So if camera is working properly, you can see your own video here. Now press OK. As a reference, you can see your own video by pressing this button, top of the software. Now the video is in not full screen mode. So by pressing the third icon of the screen camera, you will get full screen mode. That means video is working fine, properly. There is no error in the video connectivity. Now you should start the AView software. So fill up your username and password. Select server 2. Please select only that server which has been assigned to you. And as per your choice, single window mode, multiple window mode. Press login, it will get some time, it will take some time. If you will get a problem related to the login, that means problem in the port number 8700. You can check by using internet. Open Internet Explorer, type 59, the same IP address, colon, @700. You will get LCDS data website. That means port is open. If you will not get that part, that means port is blocked. So you have to open that port in router as well as firewall of the proxy server. So now enter in the classroom. Select class. You will have to select research methodology there. Double click on that.
Open the code in router as well as in firewall.
Yes. Yeah. Type that IP address and colon @700 in the address bar and check that LCDS data website, are you getting or not? If you are not getting, that means port is blocked.
These are the type of data.
To connect MySQL database and the desktop application, we are using here LCDS, Lifecycle Data Services. For that purpose, we are using port. Yes, that means port is open. If you will not get, that means port is blocked. So now you can receive the transmission, but you have to configure camera and microphone for this AVIO software. So now press settings button. Select your camera. If you will not get video device there, that means you have updated Adobe Air. So please uninstall Adobe Air, uninstall AVIO, and reinstall Adobe AVIO software again. So along with AVIO, Adobe Air will automatically install. So select your device, select your microphone. Sometimes forget that suppose the USB is default, then you should select SigmaTel audio device there, because you will use your own device of the PC's device, audio device. You are not using EasyCaps audio device. So select SigmaTel there, whatever you have, SigmaTel, it could be SigmaTel, Realtek, SoundMax, whatever you have, just select that device only. And video quality. The upload bandwidth is too high, you can use 512, otherwise use only 128 kbps.
Okay, for upload.
Upload means your video encoding.
For how much we can go for the higher one?
If you have adequate bandwidth, we will provide that. This is the criteria we have defined.
If 2 is there, we can go for the next.
Yeah.
2 Mbps.
As per your bandwidth. So if you do not have, use only 128 kbps. And this is the reception teacher side video quality. If you have too much download bandwidth, you can select medium or high quality. The default is lowest quality. Now save the setting and press start button to start the stream. That stream will go to server. So now as a reference, you can see your own video here. That means the streaming is working fine. If you are not getting video right hand side pop up, that means problem in the connectivity or streaming server. If you will get that video, that means streaming is fine, teacher can see us. Now under the users, there is a hand raise button. This is the hand raise button. Whenever participant has some doubts, the operator, AV operator, press that button. When you press that button, the question mark teacher can see against your institute name. So teacher will select you and interact with your center. And in this student video, you can see the interaction part of other centers. You will not get your own video there. Only other centers video. So now video is okay. For audio, suppose that cable goes to amplifier. So connect that cable to middle, green color. This is the output of the PC. So output goes to amplifier. Now you have wired or wireless device. So if you have wired mic, connect.
Yes, Mufakam Ja.
So
go ahead.
So the amplifier is working properly. That means if you receive that video
in
audio.
In case of flow over surfaces.
So
how do we define that?
There is a converter. Phono to 3.5 mm to connect that cable in PC. You will need that connector. So this is the converter, phono to 3.5 mm, because this big part you cannot connect in the PC. Jack phono female to 3.5 mm male.
But direct cables are also there.
If you have, you can use, no problem. So suppose you are using wired mic, connect that wired mic. If you have only single amplifier, connect that cable direct to the mic in option of the PC, like that. Please do not use any amplifier in between the PC and microphone.
You are using single.
Yeah, single amplifier. If you are using wireless mic, take output from the wireless receiver and another end of the cable inserted in mic in. So before says the interaction start, just check that audio is coming or not. So you have selected in AVO, Sigmatel or Realtek, whatever device you have. Before going to AVO, just make proper connection or proper configuration of audio. So double click on the volume control. Select options, properties, and recording. Press OK. Now I have inserted that cable in mic in rear port. So you should select rear mic. Now the default selection is line in option. So audio will not come. So select rear mic. This is the volume control of microphone. If you have Sigmatel device in your system, double click on volume control, select options of window, properties, recording, press OK. Options, and select that rear microphone. If I am using right now mic in option, so I have selected mic in. If you will use line in, select line in. This window is only for Sigmatel. If you have Realtek device in the machine, so there are two type of Realtek devices. Go to control panel and select Realtek from there. So this is the screenshot of Realtek. Press second tab, mixer, and select device here also. Suppose you have insert that cable in line in or micro mic in, select that proper connections here also. So otherwise we will not receive your audio. And you can see volume control of the microphone there also. In some of the PC you will get that the screenshot of this kind of the device. So you will not able to see the slider there. So that means all inputs are working together. On that time, please make sure that stereo mix is muted. Every time it should be muted, otherwise echo will generate. And this is the volume control of microphone. Under the record, the microphone volume control. So thank you so much. If you have any questions, raise.
Now only one more piece is connected.
Yes.
One mic.
Yes.
One more.
If you want to use two microphone, you should use.
You said one for teacher, one for.
No. Teacher is physically away from your center. If you want to use multiple microphone, you should use audio mixer and take output from the audio mixer. Sorry?
Array mics lagao hai configurable.
Yes, yes. No. You disconnect from there and connect direct to the PC. Otherwise, echo will generate. You cannot connect input and output in single device.